just for me, that sounds, I just, that's what I'm working towards, tribe. Van life and my HGDC boutique, the very things in life that are going to give me the freedom and also the creative expression that I really, really crave, and that simple lifestyle that I really, really want. Hey tribe, welcome to HGDC, HG Designs Crochet. I'm Heather and I'm 29 from the United Kingdom. This channel of mine is all about my journey as a crochet designer, documenting my moments, memories and making. So we're now into October, it is officially autumn. We've been having all of the rainy weather and it's a lot colder now, it gets dark a lot sooner. I'm actually really quite excited about it. Normally I kind of dread this time of year, but I'm really ready to just be wrapped up snug, to be making all of the things and just to hunker down a little bit really. And yeah, I'm really ready for that. I'm ready for cozy nights by the fire, cute meals, snacking, all of the snacks, watching films and making moments and memories. So I've got a finished object for you, because last week I was away. I went on holiday to Derbyshire, which is about an hour and a half from where I live, and we went to sort of a rural part of England, and it was absolutely divine. I loved it, loved every second of it, even when I was cold. And let me tell you, I got cold. So I went away with my other half, and Brad and I stayed in a lodge, and it was wonderful. It had everything we needed. There was a log fire and there was a hot tub, so we had everything we needed and all of the luxury as well. It was absolutely beautiful. So we spent the week, we went on Monday and came back Friday. And whilst we were there, we visited local areas. So we were quite lucky in that we can both drive. Brad drove us there and he did all the driving for the week, which is crochet time. So I was really grateful for that. Because where we stayed was about 2 miles or so from the nearest village, Lognor. And that village was tiny in itself. It had a pub. It had a general store, like not even a brand or a chain store, just a store run by the locals, and then people's houses, and that was it. And then we were about 2 miles out from there, in the middle of nowhere basically, just surrounded by fields and cows, on this really nice holiday park. It was really well looked after, really well maintained. They had like their own little shop which we could go and buy logs for the fire. And also they had a shed on there which had all DVDs in it, so we could go and borrow DVDs, and there was all board games and things like that as well, which is really cool. So we was there for the week in the day, and I've took loads of vlog footage. Not loads, because I was enjoying myself a lot to bother to record. You know, when you're in the moment, I was just fully enjoying the moment. But I did take some footage of some breathtaking scenery and views, and I'm going to put that in either as we go along or at the end. I really, really hope you enjoy seeing it, because I, for one, when I watch other people's vlogs, I love seeing their local area. I love seeing where they live. I love seeing how different it is. It is a way to see different parts of the world without actually leaving my own room sometimes. And honestly, it was so stunning where we went, and I just loved being in the middle of nowhere, surrounded by nothing but sheep and cows and big, big, big fields and all these cute stone walls. So a little bit about our week and the project that I worked on and finished. We went into scary caves. We went into Speedwell Coven, which, so within Derbyshire, it was a mining community. And Speedwell Coven was a cave that you had, that you accessed by a boat. I think it was like a mile that you went in this boat underground. And it was cold and it was dark and it was really, really good fun. And then we got to the bit where like they would have been excavating back in the 1700s, and health and safety didn't exist then, and these people died of like poisoning from the candles that they held in their mouth, or alcohol poisoning because they were encouraged to drink when they were down there for profits, or leukemia because the limestone in there gave off a gas and basically gave them cancer. And they worked 16 hours a day. Honestly, it blew my mind just to see how people used to work, and they had no other choice. You either was a farmer, a miner, or you were one of the very few people that had a local trade, such as, I don't know, blacksmithing, or you ran a shop or something like that, a tailor. Otherwise, you were a miner. And the kids from like the age of 7 were down there. They used to have buckets around their necks and they did a 16-hour stint. And this was a whole family thing. Everyone was down there, women, men, children. Honestly, like, seeing stuff like that makes me grateful for my 8-hour corporate job with my risk assessment for how I sit. And it's crazy out there, crazy. Anyway, we went into the scary cave and we went up some amazing hills. Like, they made my calf scream at me, but it was amazing views when we got up there. There was a couple of moments when, like, got to the top of one and Brad was like, look down. And then I was like, ooh! And froze and couldn't move because it was just a sheer drop. I think we Googled it and it was 200 and something, almost 300 meters tall. And I was stood there like, ah! But the views were stunning, just panoramic, stunning views. We went to Dovedale and Thorpe Cloud. We went over the stepping stones at Dovedale to cross the river. Honestly, it was so good. And then after our sort of day's adventure, we would then go to a pub and have a really, really nice meal, and then sort of trail back to, like, we'd go around one of the local villages and then we'd go back to the lodge, and then there'd be hot tub time, we'd start dinner, I'd get crochet time, Brad probably went back in the hot tub, I by then felt a bit too cold to be going back out in the cold, because yeah, the hot tub is warm and we could have it set to like 39, 40 degrees, which almost felt too hot to sit in. But then you had to get out of the hot tub and into the lodge, and it really wasn't that far, but it was enough then that I was frozen. And the hot shower just didn't thaw me out because it was that hot, you couldn't stand under it. It didn't have a temperature setting, so it just came out scalding hot, so you sort of splashed, and you got out, put all the layers on. So I tended to choose to sit in front of the log burner, and I'd be as close as I could get to the log burner, wrapped up in this really fluffy blanket that they had there, which I slept under, and I basically just lived under whilst in the lodge. And Brad would go back in the hot tub and I would crochet, and so I got a lot of work done. It was really, 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 really enjoyable, so, so good. I could tell you so much about it, and in all honesty, it was just so nice to get away. I like my day-to-day life, I like my reality, I like what I'm building towards, but it was really, really nice to get away, to be able to have that time with Brad, to have that time away from social media and just my phone in general, and just to focus on a project, which is here, I'm going to show you, to start another project, which is here, I'm going to show you, and, you know, just to go and do some amazing adventurous things, and just to laugh out loud, eat really well, sleep really well. So refreshing. And it really did make me, so most of you will know my word for this year has been simplify, and I've been simplifying my lifestyle, the things that I have to spend time on, rather than try and make more time in my life, because we all have a finite amount of time, I've decided to spend my time only on what's important. And so that's meant that I have downsized a lot of my possessions, the space that I live in. I have cut out things that no longer made me happy or I felt obliged to do. I've just really simplified my lifestyle, and I've seen so many rewards from it. And being away for a week with a very sparse wardrobe, I took a small suitcase with very limited clothes in, and they were mainly just functional items that I'd be warm and that I could go hiking in. To have sort of, not limited, but set meals. We ate really, really, really well, but there just wasn't cupboards full and full of snacks and rubbish, which sometimes I end up filling my cupboards with because it's quicker, easier. We planned our meals and we ate really well, and I did feel a lot better for that as well. We slept really well, so normally no one would be surprised if I'm up till 1 a.m. working on something, but we sort of exhausted ourselves in the day, and then we were pretty much asleep by like 10:30 at the latest. And then just to wake up in the morning and not have loads of distractions of, oh, but I want to work on that, I want to work on that, and I really want to work on that. I just had my set projects, and so I just really hunkered down and got them done, and it was really enjoyable. And I didn't wake up in the morning and scroll on my phone. There was no internet, so it was pointless to do that. And I didn't really want to do that either. I was enjoying just being in our little bubble. And in actual fact, this morning, my first morning back, I woke up out of habit. I picked my phone up and started to scroll. And I was like, no, I don't do this. I don't need to do this. And I had to make myself put my phone down and reach for my project instead and go and get a proper breakfast. So it's just a bad habit. So it was just really nice to get away and realise how little you do need and what things really do make you happy and that you just find joy in. So I took with me, if you can recall, I've got my Josie Rose giant Harry Potter bag with all of the badges. And last week I showed you a colour selection, and these were for my winter wardrobe. And I'd picked these colours out because they're the colours that I tend to wear. And these were all 100 gram balls. I took them all with me. Now, one of the things I agonised about when it came to packing was what yarn to take. I had like a separation anxiety from leaving my stash. I actually messaged Brad at one point, like, I can't make my mind up on yarn. He said, just chuck a load in the in a bag and it can go in the car. And I was like, my entire stash? Can I take the entire stash? And I was joking, but I also did feel like, what if I get there and I think that the perfect colour to add in this I don't have with me? And I guess that's just very much part and parcel of loving yarn and wanting to be surrounded by it. Slight perfectionism in that I want to double check that I've got all the right colours in there, which is why sometimes I don't really get projects done because I spend so much time agonising over them instead. And I wasn't really sure how much time I would spend making. As it turned out, I was the one that got up earliest. I don't think I've always been an early riser, but certainly since I've simplified my lifestyle, I am an early riser and I enjoy spending that time making. So I would get up maybe a couple of hours before Brad and I would just play some music or a podcast. I couldn't really get YouTube to stream, so I was listening to Spotify, the Vogue knitting interviews. I listened to the one with Andrea Mowry and a few others, and they're great, great to listen to. So I was working my way through those, crocheting in the morning, and then I knew that I'd have a bit of travel time in the car, and then I needed something portable because I was going to be hiking. I didn't want to be carrying all of this. As it turned out, I did carry most of this most of the time, and I didn't care because it was yarn. So I did take some vlog footage, and I was agonising. And one of the projects I did take were these. These were all 100 gram balls. The black is the closest to 100 grams. and I was going to make a scarf and mittens out of them. And I knew I wanted my scarf to be granny squares because it's my favourite crochet motif thing to make, and I wanted to be able to wear it. And as much as I love my bright crochet, I don't really wear it, and especially with it being wintry, I knew I wanted a more muted colour palette. So I made this. I absolutely love it. So this scarf has been named Adventure, which is just the most amazing name. And it's 36 five round granny squares. And I used a 4.5mm hook. And then the colours are khaki, brown, bottle green, mustard, and the tweedy colour. And they're all Stylecraft. And I kept the bands so that I could tell you the colours. Khaki was the centre colour. Then the mustard, this one, is called gold. And then I've got the tweedy colour, which is my favourite one. This is called Stone Nep, N-E-P-P, and it's the Stylecraft Life DK range, whereas all of the rest are the Stylecraft Special, and I just really, really liked that. And it's really strange because when I picked these colours up, I already could see the projects in my mind, but then I kind of almost talked myself out of it, thinking maybe I should add more colours, and I left them, these colours out on the floor, and I kept adding other colours in from my stash. I'd walk away, I'd come back and I'd take them out, and in the end I was like, I'm going to go with my original vision. It's simple and it will work. I'm so glad that I have. And I wanted this colour to feature quite heavily, and so I decided to make it the outer round. My reason being because it kind of mutes the entire square, whereas if I'd have put one of the greens or the brown around it, that would have been the dominant colour. And I feel like this one really brings it all together because it's got flecks of black, it's got the flecks of the muted gold, and it's got flecks of brown in there. And so it really brought the whole project together. So because that was the outer edge, that is all I have left of that 100 gram ball. Not a lot at all. Obviously then the mustard was the next colour. It had less round, it had less area to cover, shall we say, and so there's more of that. Then let me dig out the rest of the bands. I just used this boys double knitting for the black, which I joined it all with. I've used over 100 grams in that. This is the second 100 gram ball that I've broken into. Then I, when I was joining it actually, I had about this much left around the edge to join. I think there was like 3 granny squares left and I'd run out. And so then I decided, well, I'm breaking into another ball, so I'm then going to go round the border and put a row of single crochet just to finish it off nicely, because if I've cracked into another ball, I may as well make some use of it. And then I don't know where the other bands are, which makes me think maybe they were accidentally thrown away. But this brown, it isn't the darkest brown in the range, it's the second darkest. It's called Walnut. I knew I'd kept that one. So the brown is called Walnut. There is one brown darker than that. And then there is a, I'm just missing the band for the bottle green, which is just here. And really, really light green, and I don't wear it often enough, so I've added that in. So there's 36 squares, and I wanted it so that I could wear it with one edge hanging down, because that's how I normally like to wear my scarves, and so that there's a decent hang. Let me thingy up a bit. Can you see? I managed to press my remote as I was putting my scarf on. I didn't realise I wasn't recording anymore. So let me show you that again. So I've made it so it's got a decent hang. So it hangs quite low. And I am tempted maybe to add another couple, but I'll explain why I haven't in a minute. And so that looks really nice, snuggly. The colours work really well. Because I've done it two squares thick, it gives you a really nice warmth. Obviously you can see all my hair. I've got a black winter coat, I've got a barber jacket that I got off eBay, and this will look really nice with that. And it goes, the colour palette goes with my office wardrobe, work in a corporate setting. But with this scarf, I also wanted to make a cowl. And then I was kind of toying with the idea and just arguing with myself, because I was saying to myself, well, I'll make a cowl and I'll make it in different colours. And I was like, what's the point? Because this is going to be the basis of my winter wardrobe. So this should go with pretty much any winter outfit I want to put together. And then I was like, also arguing with myself, saying, if I want a cowl, the days I've worn the scarf, I'll be annoyed I don't have the cowl. And the days I have the cowl, I'll be annoyed I don't have the scarf. So I thought, why not just simplify matters and make this convertible so it's versatile for whatever it is I want to wear it for. Because as I've said before, I have set outfits in my life, and they are my work wardrobe, then my adventure wardrobe and gym and chill life. So what I did, which I'm quite pleased about, is I added this extension, and it just looks like rows of black, because that's what it is. But then when you turn it to the inside, to the back of the squares, I've added buttons. I've put four black buttons from my stash onto here, and then on the other end I have put, and I've still got two ends to sew in, but it's still finished. The same again, but I've put buttonholes directly into it. So when this is hanging, you won't really be able to see that there's buttonholes. It won't distract you from the overall look. And I've put those on the inside so that they can be hidden, so you don't see them. But then it means that I can button my scarf and make it into a cowl. I saw that Andrea Mari design, can't remember what it's called, but one of her shawls has got buttons on it, and I loved how it was versatile. And so that's definitely been my inspiration. And I was thinking of making that project actually. And so it's buttoned, you can't actually tell. Now, black's not the best colour to show you in, I know, but because I've put the buttons on the inside, it means that it almost looks seamless. And so then I can put this on and wrap it round into a cowl. And I picked the amount of squares I did because I get two wraps with enough, you know, so I'm not strangling myself, and it's just perfect. It's the most perfect project ever. I absolutely love it. And not only do I love that it's convertible, I love all the memories that I've stitched into it, because I was making this as we were hiking and as we were waiting to go down into the cave, and in the mornings on the most amazing holiday that I've genuinely ever had. And it's been named Adventure by Brad because of the adventure that you have when you're wearing and making this scarf. Isn't it amazing? Also, another way I like to wear it, let me just unwrap myself and my hair. Another way to wear it is to unbutton it, and I'm sure if you lot make one of these, which I do want to release this pattern, and I know I keep saying that, but this one's so simple to do. All I need is some photos, and then this one will be up for my Patreons. what another way, and I'm sure once you've made yours you'll have numerous ways that you like to wear them, is fold it in half like this and then wrap it around and by doing that it looks a lot neater, which makes me happy, but also you're getting even more thickness. And then I just button it like this, like this, that's the third one, that's the fourth one, and then I just tuck that bit in there. I just love it. I want to take it off. I'm not taking it off. I'm wearing it forever. So this is my new scarf, convertible scarf, convertible cowl, called Adventure, and isn't it just divine? I'm so pleased with it. And even now it's autumn, I can wear like my denim jacket with a woolly jumper underneath and boots and leggings, and I'll be warm. I'll be cozy warm. So I'm really, really pleased with it. So pleased with it, I'm not going to take it off now. So as I said, I made 36 squares. Originally, I made 24 because I was just going to have it as a hanging down scarf. I didn't feel the need to have it really, really long. And then the idea of having it as a cowl came about, and so I added more squares because I wanted the two perfect wraps. And I actually sat in a pub with Brad. We'd just ordered the most amazing bangers and mash. It was a gorgeous meal. And bangers and mash is sausage and mashed potato, for anyone that doesn't know. And yes, that's not vegan, I know, but it was absolutely gorgeous. Like, the sausages were from a local farm and it just tasted so good. So much better than the stuff you get around here. Anyway, back to this. Sat in a pub waiting for food, and I just sewn the edge all the way around to join the first 28 squares I'd originally gone with. And then I said to Brad, oh, I'm thinking about making it into a cowl and I want to be able to wrap it and it join up. And so I kind of held the two edges and was like, right, I need this to join up. And he was like counting, I think you need to add maybe four more in length. And so I did, and here we are. Oh, it's really, really warm. It does what I want it to do, which is it's a scarf and a cowl. I can wear it whichever way I want to. You can fold it up to make it like extra thick, or you can just wrap it around really messily. It's going to go with my wardrobe. What do you think? Put in the comments below what you think. Would you wear one? What colours would you do yours in? Buttons or no buttons? I think the buttons are a winner. I used 4 random ones from my stash. You could go to a charity shop or whichever shop and just pick some up. Decided to go with black because I was trying to hide them. Originally I was picking out some nice brown ones, but I thought they would look better on a cardigan where I want them on show. And if I'm going to go to all the effort of hiding these buttons behind, sort of on the back of the scarf, I should just put black ones. So I've done this. This beautiful scarf is called Adventure. I was going to put pom-poms on. In my head, there's a pom-pom on either end here. And then I've decided not to. And my reasoning being is, once this is buttoned up, the pom-poms wouldn't be a problem because they could be the last wrap and the pom-poms could hang down, or they could go at the back out of the way. But then I was thinking pom-poms might get in the way, like when I'm hiking and whatnot. So now I was thinking about making them detachable, which is still something I could do, but this is all the yarn that I have left, and the khaki. That's all I have left. And if I make a pom-pom out of it, I will use all of that up. I'm not opposed to that idea, other than I want to make mittens and I want to make an ear warmer out of that yarn. So I'm going to make the mittens and the ear warmer and see what I've got left. this isn't going in the mittens and this isn't going in the ear warmer. So it's just how much I have left of these four when I've done my other accessories. And then I would try and make, and I wanted like a ginormous pom-pom. I guess the only way I'm going to get that is if I really bulk it out with the black. And black's easy enough to get hold of, I guess. I don't want any yarn left over, but I want to get my accessories done before I pom-pom. So, I cast on my mittens. A mitten. I have found a free pattern on Ravelry. I'll have to put the design name here because I can't remember off the top of my head. I basically looked for, I want the mitten, the ones with the flap. They're, again, so they're convertible, so that they are fingerless and then you can put the flap over and do it up and then you've got mitten hands. I find that I find it easier to keep my fingers warm if my fingers are together, whereas if they're in individual finger gloves, I lose the circulation in the end of my fingers. I want to make these and line them with a fleece, like a teddy material. Originally I was going to use this pattern because I've made these before and then lost the other one. And so I was just going to double up this yarn, and then I was looking for one a pattern with the flap. And I was going to sort of do it my own hybrid, and then I was getting stressed out because I couldn't find one, and then I just thought, well, let me find one in double knit rather than chunky, which this is, because that's double DK held double. And so now I'm doing this pattern. Decided to do the contrasting cuff in the gold or the mustard, and then I'm going in with the brown. I'm still undecided if I'm then going to do a stripe in this green, and then I want to do the whole of the top in the black. And then the thumb's going to be in khaki. I'm not using this because I don't have much, and because it's just going to look really grubby, that will show up muck straight away. So I might put some of that in because I want to make a mitten, like a string to go through my coat, so I might put some of that in. This pattern calls for, I think it's like 3 mil or 3.25s to do the cuff. I don't have that size, and also I'm a really slack knicker. Oh dear. I'm a really slack knitter, and so I decided to go with my 2.5s. I actually started off quite slack, you can see, and it's gotten a little bit tighter. I have tried it on because I know it looks too small, and I can get it on with ease. So I think that that will be fine. So I'm going to do, I've got like another 5 rows of this rib. The pattern calls for purl one, knit one rib. I've done knit two, purl two, and I've knit into the back loop so it's twisted, because I just think it gives it a better finish. So true to form, I found a pattern, I'm already changing it, but I will keep notes of the differences that I've made so that if anybody wants to make a pair they can do. I'm not a huge knitter, and this has taken quite a while to get this far, but I do think that because crochet eats so much yarn, to crochet mittens I'm going to need more yarn, so I decided to knit them because this will go more than far enough. I'm going to do the majority of this in black because that's the main colour that I wear, but I just really had to do this. It's almost like 70s or something. I just love the colours. So, and just to show that they come off pretty easy, I need to do about 5 more rows of rib, then swap up a needle size, and my next needle size, I have 2.75s or 3.5s. I'm going to do the 3.5 because that's a whole needle size up, and do a few rows and see how it looks. As I said, I'm going to line these as well so that they're extra warm, and hopefully next time I go away on a little adventure, whether it be a day trip or an extended stay, and I get to walk up a crazy hill or go down a scary cave, I will have this to keep me warm, my ear warmer, because the wind burn on my ears as I went up the hills was crazy, and I was like, I put my rain mac on my raincoat, and then I'd tied my scarf that I've made before around my ears like some old fisherman's wife because I was so cold. I actually borrowed some boots and the coat from a friend because I haven't had anybody to go on huge walks like this in such a long time that I no longer have any of my own outdoor stuff. So I'm definitely asking Santa to get me my own walking coat in black and my own walking boots in black. So I want to have this, my ear warmer, my mittens. I'm thinking of maybe making a snood, just a bit of knitted material about this big that I can then wear. I'd probably just do it in black, which I can put under here so that there's no wind chill here at all. Because this keeps me very, very warm and I can tuck it in, but I know that if there's anywhere that air can escape or come in, I will be cold. So it might be better to have a snood for the very, very windy, cold walks. And then socks. I want lots of socks as well. So this is my mitten and this is Adventure, and the mittens are going to match. I don't know if I'll name the mittens because it's not likely to be my pattern. Then one of the other amazing things that happened on this holiday, because Brad planned it all, I take my hat off to him. He did a really, really good job and we had so much fun and we did some really cool stuff. He planned a yarn stop. This is how you know that it's like the real deal, right? He planned a yarn stop. So we went and did loads of fun, and then we went to a local yarn shop. Like, we had food and we went to the yarn shop, and that was the best day for me without a doubt, because we did the cave, which was scary and cold, and I was really thrilled by it. And then we went up the hill and that was exhilarating, to see this huge steep hill and think, I'm never going to get up it. And then we was up it within like half hour or something. The views were amazing. And we went and had a really, really nice meal in a really, really nice pub. And it was so warm in there and it was just cute and inviting. There was also a girl in there wearing a really cool outfit, which I was totally vibing off. Anyway. I had the best company all day. We had so many laughs. It was just really, really good. And then we went to a yarn shop. I got yarn. So I went into a shop called Y-Wool, W-Y-E. And they had Stylecraft, which is what I've used to make Adventure. And so I've decided to make... excuse me. I've decided to make a mini adventure for my niece. She's 4. She's going to need a scarf for winter. So I've decided to make one of these for her. She would definitely have pom-poms on hers. And I went with pinks. I saw this and knew that she had to have this really, really bright pink. I mean, it's not neon like it's showing up, but it's definitely bright. It's called Fiesta. And then I'd seen this one online. It's called Mushroom and it's like a lilac-y pink. It's very, very light. And I'd seen it online and I hadn't actually seen it in the shop, and I love the colour, so I got that to go with it. And then I picked out, I wanted an actual pink, so I went with Candy Floss. I've had this before as well. They are really blowing out. And then I picked this one up, which is Pale Rose. And then I needed one more pink and I couldn't decide. And so actually Brad picked this colour and he did really well. He went with Blush and it's like a peachy pink. And so these are the 5 colours for Kyra's, oops, scarf. What I'm going to do is do 4 round squares put together with this, and I'm only going to do the one row rather than the double row that I've got, and I think I'm going to do about 12 squares, so it's relatively long so she can get the wraps. And then I'm going to put buttons, some pink buttons. I'm going to put it together in that one, pretty sure. So, oh, I've dropped one again. that's going to be Kyra's blanket. Now, I'm trying to block out the light behind because it is blowing them out, but that's going to be Kyra's, did I just say blanket? That's going to be Kyra's scarf adventure. And then whatever's left, I want to make her a pair of mittens as well. So we will be matching. Mine will be in these quirky colours and hers will be all pink. So adorable. And then I picked up this for me. It's a ball of sock yarn. It's Italian. It's Adrafil. It's 75% superwash wool and 25% polyamide. And it's this brown colourway. The colour is Farbe, F-A-R-B-E, probably pronounced it completely incorrectly, but it's brown. I'm going to make a pair of socks, actual day wear socks out of that. 50 grams is more than enough for me to make a pair of socks. If I wanted it to go a bit further, I could put a contrasting cuff, but these are just going to be boring socks, so to speak. I'm just going to do some sort of textured pattern. I might even do the dotty socks again with these, and these will then be a part of my day wear wardrobe because they are neutral and I need more neutrals in my life. And in actual fact, I got more yarn than that because we stopped off at a Aldi to get food to stock up the lodge for the week. And when we were there, I picked this up. So we hadn't even been on holiday an hour and I managed to find more yarn. And I got this grey double knit from Aldi. It's £3.99 for four balls. It's 100% acrylic. But this is going to be for another one of my granny square jumpers. So when I'm doing fuchsia, I'm going to finish it in fuchsia and then remake it in this to check that my pattern's correct. And then that will be the colour that I will be more likely to wear because I'm going to put it in. I'm going to make the squares out of colours like this, and then I'm going to actually sell the fuchsia one because I won't wear it, it's too bright for me, I know it is. And also I'm not likely to wear a granny square jumper and a granny square scarf. I don't know if I'm that adventurous. We'll have to see when it's done. Double granny squares. We'll see. So. Yeah, I had such a good holiday. I got more yarn. I was indulged. It was luxurious. It was so simple and rustic and had the best time ever. And this is the outcome. Doesn't it look gorgeous? So please comment below on what you think of my new scarf adventure. What colours would you make yours in? Would you use buttons or would you just, because you could rather than use buttons, when you join this up, just join them together so you don't need buttons, but then it's not convertible. So is the convertible versatile the way forward? Because I really feel like it is. So I'm going to go now. I'm going to carry on working on these. I'm going to get this vlog edited and I will see you again in a week's time. Big shout out to my Patreons. I have more now. The tribe is growing. It's great to see you all there. Every week I do the post inside HGDC, and that goes out on the Saturday. So my Patreons get an update before anyone else, and I show pictures of what I'm working on, my inspiration, and anything else in my day-to-day life that is influencing my crochet world. Which is pretty much everything. So thank you so much, and it's great to see you all there. And thank you for all of you for getting me over 1,000 subscribers. It isn't about the numbers, but it was great to hit that milestone and see how many people are joining the tribe and loving being here. So I'm gonna leave you now from my crochet world. I've just realized I've got my lark's foot blanket, granny square blanket, this, there's a load of granny squares there, granny bag here, loads of yarn behind me, all the yarns going off in here, a little bit of knitting. Thank you so much for being here. I hope you enjoy seeing the vlog footage as much as I enjoy being there. It was wonderful. I can't put it into words enough. I had the bestest time with the bestest person. I had such a good time. and it really puts into perspective how much we need on a day-to-day basis, how little clothing we really do need, like how little food we really need to put in our cupboards, and how much stuff we need to consume and how much stuff we need around us, as opposed to how much we should be doing and having fun going to do, and how many experiences there are out there, and how having a simpler lifestyle really does allow you to enjoy life more. And that's what life is about. It was just so, so good, and it really has got me thinking more and more about van life. I would love to convert a van and live in it, and for a while I know I would carry on doing my full-time job, but it would just mean that in the evenings I could park somewhere nice, at the weekends I could get out and go, I could go places like Derbyshire and just stay overnight, and maybe long term I'd be able to drop my working hours because I'd have less outgoings and be able to maybe have a 3 or 4 day weekend and a 3 or 4 day working week, and that just sounds so much nicer. Just for me, that sounds, that's what I'm working towards, Tribe. Van life and my HGDC boutique, the very things in life that are going to give me the freedom and also the creative expression that I really, really crave, and that simple lifestyle that I really, really want. Take care, Tribe. Happy making moments and memories.